Luckily, I'm able to present to you Richard Rodgers himself, the composer of, I don't have to tell you, some of the greatest scores that we've known in the last 25 years, Oklahoma, Carousel, and South Pacific, to say nothing of The King and I and a host of others. Dick, we're delighted to have you here.
It's nice to be here.
I'd like to start, first of all, Dick, with a very strong feeling I have, and that is that you are, whether you know it or not, and although you don't wear a mustache, you are the Waltz King of America. And this has come about in a very original and wonderful way. You have written waltzes which I think are exclusively American, and for the first time introduced into music a new feeling for a form that had been brought to its peak by Johann Strauss. What do you have to say in your own defense on that point?
I think I can defend myself in this way. The three-quarter time signature has been sadly neglected in popular music, and I felt for a long time that it had more validity than it had been given a chance to show. I think there's possibly even more energy, vitality, in three-quarter time than there is in four-quarter time, for instance.
Well, it's because you have that conviction and that feeling that your waltzes have turned out to be the wonderful things they are. I'd like to tell you a story which involves a Columbia artist. His name is Joseph Seghetti, the violinist, and I met him one day in a Cleveland railroad station. He was waiting for a train, and Yoshka, as he's affectionately known, travels a little bit like a Chinese family moving before a flood. Their oranges falling out of his pockets, half-finished sandwiches wrapped in wax paper. And I went up to him and I said, how are you, Yoshka? And he said, oh, so-so. I said, what's the matter? I couldn't sleep. I said, why couldn't you sleep? He said, there's some tune. I don't know what it is, but I can't get it out of my head. I said, what is it? He said, I don't know. It keeps going down, down, down. I said, well, sing it to him. He said, well, it's something like this. Da-dum, dum, da-da-dum, dum, da-da-dum, dum, da-da-dum. I understand what he means. Lover, of course, that's the name of that tune, is one of the most entrancing of all your waltzes. What show was that in? I've forgotten.
Well, that wasn't in a show, Goddard. That was in a moving picture. And it was written as an incidental bit. It wasn't ever meant to be a hit. Jeanette MacDonald sang it, driving in a one-horse trap through the woods, and actually she sang the song to the horse. Had a different lyric.
Well, an awful lot of horses have caught on since.
It was picked up, and we wrote a commercial, apparently, lyric, and it got to be popular.
Has that happened with a lot of your songs? I think it has, hasn't it?
Oh, you mean the sleepers?
So-called, yes.
Yes, a great many.
I think perhaps some of the reason that your songs have their staying power is they are, just as you said, they are not written to be hits. I have the feeling that people who go out to write hits seldom do.
Well, I think that's partly true. But I do think that what happens with these so-called sleepers is that a small band of fans pick them up. They're people who have a certain slightly deeper understanding than the average man in the street. And they become fans and play these things publicly and semi-publicly. A lot of them are what we call saloon songs. They play them in these little nightclubs after hours, maybe just one pianist. And a certain small band of people learn these songs and go out and sing them and play them, and eventually they become popular.
I know exactly what you mean, Dick, because you know that I have been one of your fans for a long time. It's a source of not real irritation, but slight irritation to discover now, as I'm getting older, that songs which I thought were my private possession now have a large public. Little songs like My Funny Valentine, which I was able to embarrass people who didn't know it, and now is a well-known song, and I'm delighted that it is, of course. Let's continue for a moment with this waltz thing. I really think that your contribution here is probably even greater than you think. I tell you why I say that. The waltz tempo, as you have analyzed it correctly, does have a special vigor of its own, But it seems to me that in traveling around the world, as I do sometimes, I hear more of your waltzes than any other type of song that you've written. It does have some kind of an international stamp, and you have certainly moved the center of waltzes to America. I think we ought to play some of these on this wonderful record that you've made with the New York Philharmonic, and we're going to talk about that in a moment, is a medley of waltzes, which includes Lover, Falling in Love with Love, The Most Beautiful Girl in the World, and Oh, What a Beautiful Morning. Let's hear a bit of that.